Hey guys, welcome back to Visual Basic Crazy Tutorial. And in this lesson, we're gonna create our first database and make a login system for our users. So before I start this video, I just want to tell you some stuff about the database. So normally, database system allows you to store data as a table in your computer or external server, and you can access that data anytime from your computer until you delete that table. So there are mainly three types of database in Visual Basic 2010. Access database, local database, and server-based database. Local and server-based database are the SQL database. All these databases need 5 procedures to be connected with your software. That is connection, comment, data reader, data set, and data adapter. So in my future videos, I'm gonna hopefully be able to show you to work with all kinds of database. But for today, I'm just gonna go with the local database connection and default data set of Visual Basic. So with that being said, let's get rolling. Hey guys, welcome back. So let's start the project by clicking on the file, any project, and click OK. Alright, so the first thing I want to talk about it's about the interface. So for this project, I'm going to need Database Explorer and Data Sources. So if you cannot find data sources, just go to Tools, Settings, and reset everything, and you should have data sources in your left side. And if you cannot find the Data Explorer, just go View, Other Window, and Database Explorer. Great. Alright, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a database. So go to Solution Explorer and select our application there, and right click on any blank space and go to Add a New Item. Now go down a bit and there should be local database, and there is service-based database that we're not going to cover that in this tutorial. So let's select the local database and add, and there is data set, next, and just finish. Alright, so as you can see, our data set has been added in our data sources. Great. Now in our database explorer, there is database 1, so just click on this little icon and you should see tables there. So just right click on this table and create a table. Alright, I'm gonna name this table users. Alright, so in a table there is columns and there is rows. So we're gonna first make the columns. So for the first column name, I'm gonna put ID as a column name, and the type is gonna be big int, which allows me to have 8 length, and that's gonna be enough for our ID. Well, data type can be integer, string, or whatever you want. So yeah, so allow nulls, I'm gonna put no, and unique, yes. So that means ID cannot be duplicated, so it's always be unique, and allow nulls means it cannot be null. And I'm gonna put primary key to yes. That means whenever the first time, it's gonna put any values to the ID first. So yeah. So next, I'm gonna create another column name with this username, and I'm gonna put there char as a data type, and I'm gonna put length 30. Let's create another one, password, and that's gonna be also char, and the length is gonna be 30. Click OK, and our table is ready. So as you can see, there is a user, and column has there is 3 columns: ID, username, and password. Great. Now we have to put some values inside our table. So right click on the table and show data, table data. So click on that, and let's put the ID 1, username, let's put admin, and password to pass, and let's put 2, username to Tom, and password to 123456. Alright, so our table is ready. Let's just close that up, and we have to add that table to our data set now. So go to the data sources and select our data set. Now click on this little icon that says configure data sources with wizard. So click on that and select our table and click on finish. Alright, so we got here our whole table that has a little pop-up menu there that says data grid view and detail view. So if you select grid view, it's gonna give you all these grid views like that. Alright, and if I debug that, as you can see, all those values are showing there. Great. But we're not going to use that because we're going to use the login form. So I'm just going to select that and delete everything from there. Go over to the form and delete everything from inside of that form also. Alright, so now that's done. Let's just go ahead and select our data set. Now click on this little icon that says edit data set with designer. Click on that, and here as you can see it says right click here to add new items. So right click there, and that's gonna put our table there and add table adapter. Great. So we're gonna manually select everything there. So we're gonna create a query. So right click, add query, and then new SQL statement. Then click on next, and there is five options there. I'm not gonna cover that all in this video. I'm just gonna go ahead and select the second option, which will give me just single value. Maybe in future videos I'm gonna show you all this update to need and insert all this stuff. So alright, so I'm gonna select second option and go ahead next, and here you can type your query, but I'm just gonna use query builder for now on. Alright, just drag that, select username and password. Alright, let me just make a little bigger. Alright, so for the username, I'm just gonna select that, go on to filter, and I'm gonna type equals and then add the red sign, and you can type anything you want. For now, I'm gonna say user text box. Why you say that? Just a minute, I'll show you. And you equals at the rate user, sorry, this one is pass text box. Alright, so that's done. Now go ahead and click OK. Before I click OK, let's just test. Click on that, execute some weird values there, and click OK, and nothing is there. And go ahead and now click admin and pass. Click OK, and the value is there. So yeah, that query is working. So click OK, and then next. And then it'll ask you to give name for your function. So I'm gonna name this login query. And then click next and finish. Alright, so the login query has been added to our user table adapter. Great. Now go on to our form, and let's create login form. So I'm gonna get a button first, then level and text box. I'm gonna copy this text box and also this level. I put this level there and button there. Alright, just resize the form. Alright, so our login form is ready. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna select the button first, and I'm gonna go over the new property. I'm gonna say login underscore btn, and for the text property I'm gonna say login. Select the level and go over to the text property. I'm gonna say username, and for the second one I'm gonna say password. Position that correctly. Okay. Now select the text box, and I'm gonna change the name to username underscore txt, and this one is password underscore txt. Alright, so now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna double click on this login form. So double click. Alright, so here first I'm gonna create a variable, so dim user. So users is gonna be our query result. We just made the query in our data set there. So the result is gonna come up using this user variable. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna call this user table adapter. So I'm gonna say user table, users table adapter, this one dot, then our query name, which was login query. Let me just show you this one, login query, and then look what happens when I use parentheses. It says user text box as string. Remember, we put a put that @ and then user text as a filter, so it's coming out there. So user text box as string. So what are we gonna do here? We're gonna say username underscore txt dot text, and then comma for the pass text box. We're gonna say password. Password underscore txt dot text, and close the parenthesis. Great. Now our user is ready, which is the result of our query. So if we put the right username, it's gonna give us the right results. So we're gonna say if the user is nothing, then it's gonna say message box. It's gonna say username or password is wrong. Alright, and else it's gonna say in the message box you have just logged in. Alright, so let's just test this out. Let's hit debug, and if I put something will fail in there and click on login, the username password is wrong. If I click admin and password to pass, login, you have just logged in. Wait, let's say Tom, and 123456, which was our table value. So yeah, you have just logged in. If I put something 7 maybe and login, yeah, username and password is wrong. That's it for this tutorial, guys. Hope you liked this video. If you did, just give it a like, and if you have any questions, doubt or suggestions, just comment below, and I will see you guys in the next tutorial. And make sure you click on the subscribe button, and don't forget to share with your friends, families and Facebook. And make sure you click on this little bell icon, that's gonna send you a message whenever I make videos in future.